Good evening, everybody, and welcome to another edition of Spartans Basketball here on LCAT. I'm Colin Casey. As the Esau Middle Spartans host the West Springfield Terriers in this girls' basketball affair on the Friday before Christmas here on December 23rd. Spartans looking for their first victory of the season. They are 0-2 to start with losses to Chicopee Comp and South Hadley. This is their second home game of the season. West Springfield's played one game against Westfield. Not entirely sure, certain on the results of that game, but I believe West Springfield came away with a victory. So they look to continue a good start. First shot of the game, no good. And it'll be Selena Pereira the other day. Starters for the Spartans, it's Pereira, Whitehead, Sharon, Curley, and Gagne. Gagne, or rather, Pereira. Sharon double-teamed, goes up, and the Spartans come away with the rebound. Gagne, nice look inside to Sharon. The layup is good, and the foul. And the Lady Spartans get on the board first. Beautiful pass from Gagne. And the free throw is good. Andrews. Pass is stolen by Gagne. And Pereira. Tough shot, doesn't go. And it'll be Madison Conway the other way. Cross court pass. And driving baseline, it's going to be off Esau Meadow. Been quite the week for Spartan sports. Great start to the week Monday with the boys basketball team picking up a huge win against Putnam. And if you have not seen that game yet, I highly suggest looking at it here on our YouTube page, LCAT01028 at youtube.com. One of the better games you'll see in recent memory for the Spartans, as it'll be West Springfield ball. Also, boys hockey team picking up a huge win yesterday, 5-1 victory. It's been a quiet offensive game through the first minute 44. It's West Springfield trying to get on the board. That pass was untouched. West Springfield corrals it. Jump shot, no good, bounces out. And Pereira brings it back the other way for the Spartans. Whitehead loses it, and it will be Conway. And they're going to get Gagne for a hand check. First foul on the Spartans. Inside pass, knocked away by Curley. Pereira drives and somehow hits that shot. And it's 5-0. Great shot from Pereira. Pass inside, stolen. Spartans defense doing a fantastic job early. Gagne gets her own rebound. She can't finish there, and we're gonna get a timeout. Looks like an injury timeout. West Springfield player shaken up. She appears to be okay. That was Nicole Vila, junior. Pretty young team. All the starters, none of the starters, seniors for the Terriers. They have two on the roster, but I didn't see either of them in the pregame layup lines. I believe they're injured, and West Springfield finally on the board. And it's Vila after getting the wind knocked out of her. Picks up West Springfield's first points of the game. Last touch by Whitehead. Now the Terriers can tie the game in the three ball. Ball batted away. There's a three-point attempt. No good. It hits above the wire, and they're not going to call out of bounds. It'll be Spartans ball regardless, but could have been some free points for West Springfield. Have they gotten the shot to fall? As that is out of bounds once you hit that, the white pipes right above the basket. West Springfield picks up their second team foul. Cafaro, bounce pass. And it's going to be West Springfield ball. Spartans offense looked really stagnant on that possession, not giving a lot of help for Gagne. Ended up getting trapped in the corner. There's a good bounce pass. Three-point attempt is wide right, and it's out of bounds. Here comes a bit of a full-court press. Looks like a full-court zone defense. 2-2-1 for the Terriers. As for boys basketball, they play tonight. And what an and one right there from Anna Curley. The second for the Spartans in this game. But the boys playing at Minichog tonight. Hoping to ride some momentum after bouncing back from a tough loss to Long Meadow with a huge win over Taylen Martin, one of the best players in New England. And the Putnam Beavers, who have been just so good over the past 5, even 10 years. And Curley hits the free throw. Gives the Spartans a 6-point advantage. 3:25 remaining in the first quarter. Spartans looking strong defensively early. And they keep forcing West Springfield into mistakes. Meg Sharon. Bounce pass to Cafaro. Inside to Curley. The post fake. Gets a nice bounce pass. Finds Gagne. Spartans with some nice assists early in the game. And that's going to cause Westside to call a timeout. With 2:50 to go in the first quarter, it's 10-2 East Long Meadow. It'll be Terriers ball. Still looking to get some consistency on the offensive end. They looked kind of lost through the first 5 1/4. As Andrews with it up top. Conway gets it right back and connects on the three ball. So immediate points after the timeout for West Springfield. Conway, just a sophomore. Pereira. Faro stripped in. It's going to be on the break. Conway lays it in. or Vila rather. Vila with her second bucket of the game, and it's a one possession game. Bounce pass off a Terriers player's foot. Andrews with the steal. Nice pass up ahead, layup is good, just like that. It's a 7-0 run, and it's a 1-point game. After the foul, Whitehead checks back into the game. Sharon comes out. Nicole Coolidge also comes into the game for Anna Curley. There's a double team. Loose ball, Pereira's got it. And now it's gonna be a jump. It's gonna stay with the Spartans. Minute 25 to go in the first quarter. 10-9 Spartans. Just 12 on the shot clock for the Spartans. In the corner, Whitehead. There was a hard pass inside, and it's knocked away and intercepted. Westside with a chance to take the lead. Andrews. It's dropped loose, and that's going to be a jump ball. Five seconds left in the quarter. Spartans dominated the first half of the first quarter, and it seemed like the last 2 minutes or so, West Springfield has been a lot better than the Spartans. Coolidge inside, gets stripped. Defense really picking up for the Terriers. Let's see if they can turn it into points at the other end. Step back three, back iron. It's a loose ball. Three chances and West Springfield can't come away with a bucket. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. A good hard screen. Whitehead clearly had the paint right there. And they're going to call it on her. It's a good hard basketball play and they don't reward her, which is unbelievable. 19 seconds to go and Westside gets a Christmas present. See if they can take advantage of it. That three, no good. Rebound, Whitehead. How about that for justice? Back the other way. And that layup doesn't go. 5 seconds to go. See if Westside can get off a shot. The heave kisses iron. And the Spartans cling to a 1-point lead as we head into the second quarter. Stay tuned. Second quarter underway at Esau Meadow High School. It's a 1-point lead for the Spartans. Gagne inbounds to Pereira. Whitehead left open for three, no good. That's a couple of steps taken there. Andrews at the corner. That's long. The putback, and there's a rebound for Gagne. Oh, what a pass. Whitehead can't finish. And a good job rebounding from Westside. Westside just hasn't quite been able to get the lead. They've been within one for quite some time now. Runner hard off the backboard. There's a pass ahead for Sharon on the break, and she is stripped. Good defense, and it'll be Spartans' ball underneath. Just under a minute gone in the second quarter. Gagne to Curley. Three from Gagne doesn't go. Back the other way. Knocked away by Sharon, out of bounds. And a timeout will be taken from the Spartans. Both teams, through the past 3 or 4 minutes of play, have been phenomenal. It is 10-9 Esau Meadow. Three off the inbound, no good. Offensive rebound, another three, that's to the right. And we're going to see a tie up. Gagne with her hands on it, and it'll stay with West Springfield. 6.5 to play in the second. A lot of outside shots from West Side throughout this game. Look, that shot was deflected. And the Spartans back the other way, looking to extend their very slim 1-point lead. It's been that way for a good 3-4 minutes of play. And that's going to be a foul on Sharon to prevent the layup. But West Side could take the lead from the free throw line. Andrews can't hit the first. Still a chance to tie. Can't get either to fall. Curley the rebound. Gives it off to Pereira. Height advantage for Curley, and it can't get the kind bounce. Ball stripped, and once again, Gagne on the floor, causing the tie-up, and it'll be Spartans' ball. Comes another zone press. And a nice steal from Andrews on the break. And West Side finally takes the lead and ends the scoring drought from both teams. Nice pass. And Gagne will head to the line. She'll look to get the Spartans' lead right back. Vila's got two fouls. And Gagne misses the first. Second one goes. Spartans 3 of 4 from the free throw line. 11 all. That layup can't quite drop, and it will be last touched by the Terriers. Pass inside. It's batted around and last touched by West Side. Barnes struggling a little bit to get that play going. Pereira for three. Off iron. And it's Andrews the other way. Floater bounces off the rim a couple times. Doesn't fall. Gagne. Sharon is fouled. Hit on the arm. Fouls on Conway. And that was a 6-team foul, so. Not quite 1-1 yet. Still 4.5 to play, though, in the first half. So Spartans could. That's going to be a push off on Whitehead. Good call. Almost a stiff arm right there. And it'll be West Springfield the other way. Whitehead to the bench with two fouls. Floater, no good. Saved by Cafaro. Last touch by West Springfield. A good hustle play from Cafaro. Helps the Spartans regain possession. Quick congratulations to Esau Meadows' own native, or Esau Meadows, kind of redundant right there, but Esau Meadows native, Frank Vetrano, returning to the Bruins lineup last night against the Florida Panthers. He scored in his return. And hopefully see that a lot more. In the three games he's played this year in the Bruins organization, he played two games in the minors with the Providence Bruins, scored in both those games as well. That's going to be a travel. And he came back in a very memorable game in which Jaromir Jagr, the Florida Panthers forward who's been in this league since the early 1990s, he broke his tie in scoring with Mark Messier, second all time, as Curley will head to the line, second all time behind, of course, the great one, Wayne Gretzky. He's still got a ways to go to catch Gretzky at the age of 45. Absolutely no chance. I think he's a good 950 points back of Gretzky. Curley's first is off front iron. I saw something very interesting. I think around 100th all-time scoring, it's Pavel Datsyuk, former Red Wing center, great player. He is 958 points back of Jagr. As for Jagr, actually Messier, who's in third now, 958 points back there. It is 958 points to Gretzky from Messier. That's how amazing Wayne Gretzky was. And we will never see another player like Wayne Gretzky, ever. And I am certain of that. Curley, and fouled on the floor. So I think it'll be 1-1. It will be. ...12-11, Spartans lead, 3:04 left in the half. And Curley hits the front end of the 1-1. Give her 5 on the night, leads the Spartans. 3 from Gagne and Sharon, and a 2-pointer from Pereira. Second free throw doesn't go. Andrews. And they're going to get Gagne for the foul. I think that's her second and team's fifth. It is. Maddie Maurer now in the game. First free throw, no good from Madison McRobbie, the sophomore. Great game defensively from both teams. And West Springfield continues to struggle from the free throw line. Pereira. Cafaro is left wide open. Can't hit the jumper. Baseline, Andrews can't finish. And the other way, it's Maurer with a full head of steam. Loses it and smartly throws it off the defender's leg, and it'll be Spartans ball, 24 on the shot clock. Folks, stay tuned here at halftime. The couple of, I think, third and or fifth and sixth grade teams will be playing during the half. The green team versus the blue team in the scrimmage. Curley inside, and she's fouled. I think the game plan right now for the Spartans is feed it inside to Anna Curley, and it's paid off, getting her to the free throw line or sometimes getting her points. And if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Curley again hits from the line. 4 of 5 on free throws for her. She hits them both. 5 of her 7 come from the free throw line. 7 of the Spartans' 15 from the line. And Pereira with the steal. Spins away from the defender. Nice pass, Curley, mid-range. And not quite. Bats the rebound away briefly, but it's West Springfield the other way. Open three, banked home by Kathleen Bellevue. Her first 3 points of the night. And the lead down to 1. Maurer inside to Curley. That's a kick ball. And it's going to be a jump ball, and it's going to be going the other way. Interesting to say the least. Although that kick didn't look intentional, it did look like a kicking motion, and surprised that the whistle wasn't blown. Nevertheless, 50 seconds to go, and the Terriers look to take the lead. Open jumper, long. Pereira can't hang on to it. Last touched by the Spartans. And that's going to be a foul. 2 shots coming up for West Side. It'll be Andrews at the line. The foul is on Sharon, her second. So 16 fouls for the Spartans. 2 on Gagne, 2 on Sharon, 2 on Whitehead. So 3 of the 5 starters for the Spartans with 2 fouls. And again, the struggles continue as West Springfield yet to make a free throw. They've certainly had their chances at the line. Just to tie the game. There it is. And that's a big free throw to tie the game at 15. It's 3 for Andrews. He's had a handful of nice passes throughout this game. Pereira. Resets. Spartans do have to shoot before the end of the quarter, and they won't get a chance. Andrews misses the layup. And it's going back the other way. Maybe they will get a chance. Sharon with a nice pass. The finish, no good from Whitehead. And it's going to be Spartans the other way. Whitehead looking for a foul. And with 6 seconds left, Maurer checks in for Whitehead. They're going to let it roll. Deep, deep three. It's an air ball. And with 1 second to go, the Spartans perhaps will get a chance to heave one. And no, they're going to hold it. So we head to the half. Deadlocked at 15. Stay tuned for extra basketball here at halftime. Once again, Spartans 15, Terriers 15. You're watching Esau Meadow Spartans girls basketball here on LCAT. And so now some extra basketball here at halftime. As some Esau Meadow girls in town. Basketball action now. And how about that for a shot to open things up? Loose ball, and it's going to go out of bounds. That shot, no good. Rebound, blue. Layup, no good, and Green comes away with it this time. And going the other way, it is Lila Cushman. Jumper is good. And that was Ashley Stanek. Good pass. And Zeta Cruz, Molly McKittrick. Had my teams mixed up right there. Good save. But it'll be Green ball the other way. Referee for this game is Gary DiStefano. Gary also a coach for boys high school in town. His son Peter on that team, looking to make a run at a championship. Season starts after the new year. Now back to the game as that shot comes up short from McKittrick. It'll be Green ball. And that jumper short from Lila Cushman. Loose ball, McKittrick. And jumper doesn't go. Tell you what, Blue doing a great job rebounding. Pass inside. No good. Green with the rebound. That shot just misses. That's going to be out of bounds. And Green's going to make a couple of subs here. Just five for Blue, so they will keep the same squad out there. Shot just doesn't go. At three, no good. Put back, blocked. It'll be Blue ball. Yep. Now Green the other way. Blue on the break and lost out of bounds. Ashley Stanek gives it over to Cushman. Takes a shot, knocked away. Michaela Colty. And it's Green. Loose ball picked up by Blue. Both teams playing some great defense throughout this game. Blue moving the ball well. Shot is deflected. Not quite. And layup can't go. That shot from Navaya Alfonso. Shot is blocked. And we got a tie up. That jumper, no good. And McKittrick the other way. Good pass. McKittrick with one-handed jumper, no good. And a swarm of Blue players causing the tie-up. Jumper, not quite. Back the other way, it's Hannah Willits. And that's final seconds here. Kayla Colty to McKittrick, nice pass. Jumper is good. As that's Cassie Rochette who hits the buzzer beater. And hopefully some of these girls just playing at halftime will one day be playing for the East Almetto Spartans in high school. We'll be back to bring the third quarter of action in just a minute. Spartans about to run a stack here to start the third quarter. And it'll be Pereira. And it's going to be a foul that sends Sharon to the line. So Sharon looks to add to her 3 points in the first half. She hits the first. And just a about a week ago, the 125th anniversary of the first basketball game ever played. Of course, taking place just down the road at Springfield College. In that event, organized by the inventor of basketball, Dr. James Naismith, Springfield native, originally from Canada. And little did they know that basketball would become one of the most popular sports worldwide come 2016. And it has had quite the impact on lives all over the country and all over the world, for that matter, as Sharon heads back to the line after hitting both her free throws. Three fouls now on Vila. And Sharon's been automatic from the line. And a timeout's going to be taken from West Springfield. 7:17 remaining in the third. 18-15, Spartans. Just 43 seconds into the third quarter. Spartans, small 3-0 run to start, but it is significant in the fact that this game is tied heading into the quarter, and now they're up three. Gotta love simple algebra. I don't even know if that's algebra, just simple math, as Sharon, 4 of 4 from the line this half. Give her 7 on the night. That pass goes out of bounds. Boston Celtics off to a strong start against the Oklahoma City Thunder, a team that has this year's MVP. I'm going to say it now. I mean, I know we're not even halfway through the season, but Russell Westbrook's been phenomenal this year, putting up Oscar Robertson-like numbers. Could very well average triple-double this year, and that hasn't been seen since Oscar Robertson in 1961. So I don't see how you can overlook those numbers and give it to somebody else. I just don't understand how. Because without Russell Westbrook, I don't know what the Oklahoma City Thunder are. As nice shot from Whitehead, her first points. Lead up to 6. Of course, Kevin Durant no longer with the team. Such as makes Westbrook that much more of an MVP candidate. Good defense from the Spartans. And in transition, 2-on-1 the other way. Shot no good, rebound, it's Sharon and she's fouled. Fouls on Andrews are first. Already 3 team fouls on West Springfield, not even 2 minutes into the second half. Straight away 3 from Pereira, no good. And there's going to be a foul on the floor. A wild 3-point attempt, no good. And Pereira. Nice pass. Sharon, tough shot and gets it to fall. How about this start from Sharon starting out the second half? Just phenomenal. Six of the Spartans, 8 in the half. Layup, not quite. Tough shot, no good. And it's Pereira back the other way. Loose ball picked up. And foul from Gagne sends West side of the line. That is Gagne's third. And the struggles from the free throw line have been glaring for Westside. They're really going to have to start knocking those down if they want to get back into this game. And 0 for 2 from that trip doesn't help the cause. Spartans can make it double digits on this possession. And that forced pickup turns into a turnover. 18-footer, no good. And how about that steal from Whitehead? Other end is fouled hard. And she heads to the line. Nothing but net on the first. Three for Whitehead. Vila has four fouls. Both of them good. Four for Whitehead. As Meg Sharon and Anna Curley with strong performances from the Spartans so far. Curley gives her the baseline, and it's going to be out of bounds on West Side. Bad pass, and West Side finally scores their first points of the second half, about 3.5 minutes into the third quarter. Left-hand layup, no good from Gagne. A little bit strong. Andrews, quick take to the hoop, is rejected, but 18 to shoot for West Springfield. Their ball underneath the hoop. Almost halfway through the third quarter. This game's really flown by. Pretty quick paced. And Gagne gets a rebound on the miss. And foul. On Conway, her second. And Whitehead comes out, Cafaro in. Pretty small bench for the Lady Spartans, I just noticed. Looks like three active players on the bench right now. Four. Didn't see Whitehead. But still, not a huge amount of players on the bench in comparison to what we've seen in the past. And Spartans have it now. Another turnover. Pereira almost has that one taken out of her hands. And she is stripped there. Three-pointer, good. And the lead down to five on the three from Conway. She's got eight, including a pair of three balls. There's a steal from Andrews. Layup no good. And to add insult to injury, that ball might have been off Esau Meadow. She was standing under the hoop. The ball hits her on the way out of bounds. It'll be Spartans' ball. Timeout, Esau Meadow. 2:54 left in the third quarter. West Springfield not going away. They trail 25-20. Pereira takes it out for the Spartans. Five out there for Esau Meadow is Pereira, Gagne, Sharon, Cafaro, and Curley. And it'll be Gagne bringing it up the court. Needs some help. Finds Sharon. Sharon is stripped. Once again, West Springfield picking up the defense. How about that for a pass? Can't quite finish it. and a travel on the Spartans. Bellevue looking to get it in. Ball bouncing viciously. And somehow West Springfield gets it back on the other side of the court. There's a nice block from Cafaro. Boston Bruins update. They lead 1-0 in the first period behind a Ryan Spooner first period goal. They look to start to pick things up. They've been pretty inconsistent throughout the first third of the season. Fouls on the floor. Third team foul on the Spartans, and it's the first personal foul on Sarah Cafaro. Cafaro yet to score in this game. Tough shot, doesn't go, the putback does. Lead is a one possession lead for the Spartans. Defense! Whitehead. Defense! 2 minutes to play in the third. Faro. Bounce pass to Whitehead. Back out, Sharon pulls it. Nope. She gets her own rebound. Pulls it again, that's a tough shot. No good. Go the other way. Spartans were up 8 at one point. It's down to 3. Continues to be a defensive game for both teams. There's a beautiful pass. And over the back. Nicole Coolidge will check in. That's foul number 4 on Angela Sharemka. I apologize for the pronunciation there. Gagne. Bad pass. Coolidge can't corral it. And 82 seconds left in the quarter. West Springfield shot pretty well from outside. A 3 ties it. Layup bounces out. Rebound, Whitehead, the press from West Springfield. Spartans move it well and get themselves some time. And there's a foul on the arm, sends Maurer to the line. 54 seconds to go. Second foul on Andrews. And Spartans already in the bonus. 54 seconds left in the third quarter. So that's a huge advantage for Esau Meadow the rest of the way as Maurer leaves the first free throw short. Can't hit the second either. Loose ball, Coolidge fighting for it. And it's going to be a jump ball. Terriers possession. And it's going to be a push on Maurer. Jab step from Andrews, takes it baseline, right into a trap, kicks it back out, 3, bit long. Whitehead, about a 3.5 second difference between shot and game. Coolidge in the post, tough shot, no good. And it'll be West Side ball, shot clock off, 16 seconds left in the third quarter. Andrews loses it, somehow gets it back, jumper, no good. And that's gonna end the quarter. So after three, we have ourselves quite the game. Spartans lead, but only by three. We head to the fourth. You're watching Spartans basketball on LCAT. Spartans 8 minutes away from their first victory of the season, but they're going to have to fight off West Springfield to trail just by a three-point attempt. Spartans will start off with it. Gagne inbounds it to Pereira. Pereira with two on the night. Set up a few assists, though, for her teammates. Nice pass inside, and Gagne finishes it. She has five. Lead back to two possessions. Curley and Sharon started the quarter on the bench, but they're already about to check in. Good D from Gagne. It's loose. Throws it. Off of West Springfield player, and I think maybe it bounced back and got her on the way out of bounds. Must have been the case. Really hard to tell from this angle. At least the angle that I had. Andrews, baseline. His kick out, elbow jumper, doesn't go. Sharon pulls up, she tries her luck from the elbow, leaves it short. Defensive rebound for Westside. Andrews using her speed, drives. And it's going the other way. Curley, jump hook, doesn't go. Can't get her own rebound? Not quite. But it is a jump ball, I believe. Nope, it's going to be a foul on Whitehead. And that'll be three on Delaney Whitehead. Three-pointer, good. Her third of the game, Madison Conway cuts the lead back down to two. Gagne to Whitehead. Whitehead facing on-ball pressure. Crossed over and a steal. Chance to tie it. In transition, the layup is good. And West Springfield has knotted it up at 27. Kathleen Beliveau. And Whitehead is fouled. That's going to send him to the free throw line. 1-1 coming up for the Spartans. And she hits the first. So Whitehead hits her third free throw of the game. It gives her five now. And Whitehead hits them both. Six for her on the night. And the Spartans back up by two. What a game this has been, though. I mean, you got to give credit to West Springfield for fighting back throughout. And here comes two shots for the Terriers. Beliveau's done a great job setting up her teammates. She's a freshman, too. That's impressive, the way she's been passing the ball. Getting some good looks as well. Just 5 points on the night. And the first free throw, no good. So they can at least cut it to one. By the way, that's four fouls on Whitehead now. Something to keep an eye on. Second free throw will have to wait as a timeout taken, 5:50 remaining in the ball game. Second free throw. Nope, and once again, West Springfield misses from the line have cost them dearly. I mean, it's a two-point game. If they've hit five of their, probably a dozen free throws, they'd be up by a three-pointer. They have the ball, though, and a chance to tie the game. 29-27, 5.5 to play. Straightaway three for the lead. Off. And Pereira back the other way. Good defense from West Springfield. And that's the reason why they're still in this game. They've played phenomenal on defense. Baseline. Nice pass. It's good. It's a two-pointer to tie the game. It's on Nicole Vila. Not on. She made the shot. And it's travel now on Gagne. And it's tied at 29. Maurer's going to check in for Sharon. There's a three from Conway. That was for the lead. She couldn't get it. And with 4:29 to go, the game is tied at 29. Spartans have... The next foul will be 1-1. Pereira. No good. End to end they go. Andrews. This three, good! What a game from Madison Conway, her fourth three-pointer, and it puts Westside up by three. Gagne's got an open lane. She finishes to cut to one. Seven for her. 32-31. Andrews against Maurer. Sharon about to check back in. Loses it. Out of bounds off of Westside. Sharon comes in for Pereira. And Westside takes a timeout with 3:42 remaining. What a game it's been. They lead by one over the Spartans, 32-31. If you're just joining us, you've missed quite the game. The Spartans trail by one to the West Springfield Terriers, 32-31. Game the Spartans have led throughout, but West Springfield trying to steal one here in the fourth quarter. Maurer, good ball handler, gives it to Whitehead. Maurer inside to Gagne, and then Gagne gets it back and hits the jumper to give the Spartans the lead. Eight team fouls for West Springfield, six on the Spartans. Free throws could be detrimental for West Springfield as they've really struggled from the line. We got five team fouls on Vila. So she is out, and we'll see if that's a big loss for West Springfield. She does have 6 points, so she's had a serviceable night. Bounce pass, Gagne, the layup is good! Sabrina Gagne catching fire late And that puts the Spartans up three. Screen from the left, Andrews. Back up top. Beliveau, loose ball, Gagne's got it. And what a play, giving it to Whitehead. Sabrina Gagne doing it all right now. Sharon for three, hits it. Meg Sharon with a corner three ball. 38-32 Spartans. That is a first three-pointer made all night from the Spartans. .210 left, Spartans by six. Bounce pass inside, stolen. Maurer, Gagne's just been fantastic down the stretch. Gagne drives and is fouled hard. Certainly not happy about it, but she'll head to the line for two. Sabrina Gagne might single-handedly put this game away for the Spartans. Can't get the first to go. She just needs one, though, to make it a three-possession game. Can't get the second to go, but offensive rebound from Curley. Put back, bounces out. Maurer gets her hands on the rebound, or Whitehead, rather. Gagne comes away with it. No good. Spartans burn a little bit of clock, but West Springfield back the other way. Loose, lost it briefly, and it's going to be a foul. See who they give it to. And is that on Whitehead or Maurer? It's hard to tell. It's on Maurer. That's her second. And it's going to be 1-1. So every team foul the rest of the way will be free throws, whether it be 1-1 or two shots. It's 1-1 right now for West Side, and the first free throw is good from Andrews. As for the Spartans, they're in the double bonus, 10-plus fouls. 7 right now for West Side. Both good. This is where maybe West Side can make up for their troubles earlier from the line. Not good at all from the charity stripe through the first three quarters. They've picked it up a little bit in the fourth. Pass to Curley, can't finish. And Maurer, no good. I know the Spartans probably would have liked to chew some more clock on that possession. Look at that bounce pass. Layup, too strong. Minute 8 to go. Sharon. Spartans will chew a little bit of clock. Inside, stolen. And a late foul called. It's going to be on Gagne. That's her fourth. Looked like she got her on the arm with a layup. And two shots. So it looked like she was getting the layup off as she was hit on the arm. Foul's actually, they're going to give it to Maurer, actually. First is good, and Deja Andrews showing up big on the other end right now. Second doesn't go, but it is a one possession game. And it's going to be last touched by the Spartans, so a three-pointer will tie it for West Springfield. 49 seconds to go. Inbounding underneath their own basket. Open long two, bounces out. Rebound Curley. Westside does not need a foul, but they, boy, do they need to stop. Curley. And Kanye is going to slow things down. 15-second difference. And Spartans will take a timeout. 30 seconds left. 15 on the shot clock. And a three-point lead for East Long Meadow as they look for their first win of the season. The biggest possession of the game coming up for both teams, essentially, on offense and defense. On offense, the Spartans looking to get a bucket to put this away and also to take up as much time as possible. On defense, Westside trying to get a big stop, go the other end, maybe hit a three or at least a two and then foul. We'll see what happens. It's Pereira up top. Sharon. And that's going to be a foul. Not exactly what you want if you're Westside because you let a lot of clock chew. And Meg Sharon has been automatic from the free throw line. Has a chance to put it away for the Spartans. Still 23 seconds left. Two shots. Sharon with 12 on the night. Misses the first. Second doesn't go. Rebound West Springfield. They're going to slow it down. No timeout taken. A three ties it. Bounce pass inside. Fourth shot. No good. It's loose. It's going to stay with West Springfield. Any timeouts remaining? I don't think they have one. That's the problem. A dozen seconds left. West Springfield definitely going to be going for a three. It's stolen. Delaney Whitehead with a huge play underneath the basket. And now the Spartans can put this one away with just one free throw made from the line. Still 9 seconds to go, though, so if Whitehead can't hit either of them, definitely a chance for the Terriers. But here's Whitehead. She's hit four on the night. Total of 6 points. First one, can't get it to go. Now the Spartans having the struggles that Westside had earlier. She hits a second. Boy, was that clutch, and the Spartans will take a timeout. 9 seconds to go. And it's going to be really tough for the Terriers to come back, barring and 1 3-pointer. Hopefully they get our nice Reggie Miller moment. But other than that, it's looking great for the Spartans, and they're 9 seconds away from their first victory of the season. 39-35, East Long Meadow. Nine seconds remaining. They're going to roll it. They need the three. There it is. Back iron, rebound, Whitehead, and she is fouled with 1 second remaining. And the Spartans are going to win their first game of the season. Whitehead can't hit the first. She did hit that huge free throw the last trip to the line. She also made great defensive play. Second is no good, but it doesn't matter because the East Long Meadow Spartans win their first game of the season. The Lady Spartans improved to 1-2 on the season, and they win by a final score of 39-35 over West Springfield. Sabrina Gagne and Delaney Whitehead clutch down the stretch, to say the least. Especially Gagne, who caught fire in the final 2 minutes. And Whitehead puts the game on ice with that big free throw in the final seconds. For all of us here at LCAT with Jamie Rook on the camera, I'm Colin Casey. Thanks for joining us. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, Happy Holidays from us here at LCAT. We'll see you in January.